Statistically speaking, Mac being less popular than Windows makes it more secure. But is that the only reason? And is Mac security as impenetrable as fans would make it sound? You will learn the answer. Right now, actually, there is no debate between Windows versus Mac security-wise. Windows is more targeted by hackers and malware, but it's not because macOS security is impossible to crack. And I know the general argument that since the Mac operating system is Unix-based, it's more difficult to exploit. Apple itself also contributes to the security of the OS through the tight control over hardware and software availability for macOS users. But that just makes macOS generally safer, not impossible to breach. The real reason why Windows is more targeted by hackers boils down to the platform's popularity. As of January 2023, 74% of PC users stick to Windows, while the market share of macOS is only around 15%. Bluntly speaking, nobody bothers to focus on breaching Mac security, because it just ain't worth it. So, that's settled then. No need to worry about macOS security, right? Let's not take it that far. After all, about 98% of cyber attacks these days are social engineering attacks. Here's a simple example for you. You get an email that you've got a reply on Twitter. You click on the link in the email, log in, and it's gone. I'm talking about your credentials, of course, since this was a phishing email leading you to a fake website, which will steal your info on login. This isn't limited to Twitter, of course, Facebook, any other website. Phishing emails could even pretend to be friends, family, and colleagues. That was just one method of social engineering attacks, and an embarrassing amount of people fall to schemes just like that one. But besides learning the dangers of the internet and applying caution to all your actions, there are multiple things you can do. First of all, keep up with all system updates. Besides potentially upsetting visual changes, macOS updates introduce important security improvements, update malware lists, and patch vulnerabilities. Secondly, make sure all the built-in Mac security is enabled. Password protection is a must. The hardware protection comes with all M1 chips, so it should be on by default for all newer Mac users. You can also use iCloud Private Relay, Apple's alternative to a VPN, which works only on Safari with iOS 15 and above. However, if you're looking for a way to encrypt your internet connection, I'd recommend using a proper VPN, especially since iCloud Private Relay is already a paid addition, so getting a VPN won't be a sudden expense. In my experience, a good VPN can rectify the downsides of macOS online security. It can block ads, trackers, malicious websites in your browser, encrypt your connection to avoid third-party access, and even prevent IP and DNS leaks. Besides, some VPNs even come with built-in antivirus or password manager apps, which is quite good for a Mac as well. There's a couple of providers that I tested before, and I will leave a link in the description for you. Talking about antiviruses, they often provide firewalls as well, preventing unsolicited access to your device. The macOS firewall is a good example of such software, except I do not find it to be sufficient. After all, the macOS firewall does not block any access from Apple-affiliated sources, and I would prefer to limit access to my data as much as possible. There's a couple of good antiviruses with configurable firewalls I use for this purpose, and just like with VPNs, I'll leave a link for them in the description down below. There is one more nice macOS security feature though, File Vault. It applies full disk encryption, but unlike other features, this one's more aimed at not letting others access your data directly from your PC, since the encryption is only active when you're logged off the computer and disables itself when you log on. Well, what can I say in conclusion? Comparing Windows to macOS, the latter is safer. However, the macOS security software is not enough to completely safeguard users from danger, so additional software is required. VPNs, antiviruses, password managers, these all make for a strong security boost for any Mac user. So if you learned something new today, consider leaving a like and subscribing to the channel. And of course, if you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in the comments below. I'll make sure to reply to all of them. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next one.